like Elsa.
That's what the sign on the door says, miss.
Heavens to Betsy.
There's no need to come into the office, Miss Lichtman. If you accept the settlement, all you need to do is sign here.
I don't accept the
settlement. What do you mean you don't accept? I think you're pushing your luck, lady. This seems to be a ridiculously generous settlement. A $200 policy with a $20,000 payout? You should...
I don't want the money.
What do you mean you don't want the money?
I want you to investigate this case. I feel my friend may have been the victim of foul play.
Okay. Let me get the case file.
There's got to be more in these files.
Sounds like your friend took a hell of a fall. I'm sorry for your loss. Do you mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
Of course not.
What basis do you have for your claim of foul play?
Lou Buckwalter was a craftsman. I don't believe he would have made a roof that would collapse.
You want me to reopen this case based on your woman's intuition? That isn't going to happen. Take the money.
I've already told you I do not want the money. There's something wrong.
You and Buckwalter weren't married?
No.
Then how did you become his beneficiary?
We were family friends.
You expect me to reopen this case because you come in here walking that walk? Well, I'm not buying it. I think you should tell me what the hell is going on.
You really want to know?
Yes.
We were interned together on Ellis Island. Resident alien Germans whose parents had been killed by Nazis. Do you see the irony in that, Mr. Kelso? We spent 4 years there.
So the roof collapsed. Accidents happened. What exactly are you trying to achieve here, Ms. Lichtman?
Exactly what I said. I want that building thoroughly investigated.
I'm intrigued, Ms. Lichtman. I really am. But you're going to have to give me something if you want me to get involved in this.
There is a conspiracy surrounding Elysian Fields and the new houses they are building. I believe your insurance company is involved.
That's pretty heady stuff, Miss Lichtman. Flimsy, but heady.
I've told you what I know, Mr. Kelso. What are you going to do about it?
All right, Miss Lichtman. One final question.
Yes.
What's your address?
Is that usual?
Is there anything usual about this case, Ms. Lichtman?
The address is on the letter, Mr. Kelso.
The address? Not the phone number.
Mr. Benson would like to see you in his office, Jack. Upstairs. Come on, I'll walk you up. Say, whatever happened to that fella of yours, Doris? Which is it, girls? Bing Crosby or Frank Sinatra?
Mr. Benson, you wanted to see me?
Ah, yes, Jack. I'm just trying out a new putter. I notice Elsa Lickman in the lobby.
It's the weirdest thing, Mr. Benson.
Call me Curtis, Jack. This is California.
Like I said, Curtis, this is a very strange case.
How so, Jack?
That lady, Elsa Lichtman, is refusing a 20 grand payout.
Elsa Lichtman is hardly a lady, Jack. She's a jazz musician. Plays at the Blue Room in Hollywood. She has a fine pair of lungs, now that I think
of it. She's the beneficiary of this guy, Lou Buckwalter. He was killed in an industrial accident working for Elysian Fields Developments. You know Elysian?
I'm familiar with Leland Monroe. We move in similar circles.
Well, Ms. Lichtman is making some pretty serious accusations. She says the case stinks and that
she's
something
a very highly strung girl, Jack. Strung out might be a better way to put it.
It's a pretty generous payment, Curtis. I think I should look into it.
Is there anything wrong with the paperwork, Kelso?
No, there isn't, Mr. Benson.
I didn't think so. Pay the case out and get her off our backs.
I can't make her take the money,
Deal with it, Jack! Do your fucking job! Do I have to do everything?
No, sir, you don't.
Fine, Jack, fine. You know I have the greatest confidence in you.
Thanks, Mr. Benson.
Your car, Mr. Kelso.
Thanks, kid.
Children to Sunday school and take them to church.
Hey! What's your problem?
Got a job to do. Must be his blind spot. Bad driving.
That's not how my pop taught me to mix it. Someone is cutting corners. Bulldozing and starting again. Leland Monroe, the man with the grin. Looks like he doesn't like to be disappointed. I'm Jack Kelso from California Fire and Life.
I don't care if you're from the Vatican. Buzz off.
I'm investigating the accidental death of a Lou Buckwalter and...
You deaf? Do I have to beat on you?
Looks like you do. I came to see the house where Lou Buckwalter died. You were just about to offer to show me the way.
It's out the gate and three houses down to the left. Don't know what you're looking for, smart guy. There's nothing there.
Then I'll poke around in the rubble.
Fine. As long as you're out of my sight.
Falls down and then they bulldoze it. What gives here?
Piece this together. That's not right.
Keystone Films. Who gets their lumber from a film studio? Thank you.
don't know which one I like better.
Jack Kelso, California Fire and Life Investigator. I need an address on the Keystone Film Company.
The address is 658 North Wilton Place. Is there anything else?
No, thank you, ma'am.
Watch it!
I work for California Fire and Life. I'm looking into an industrial accident.
Here?
No, not here. At a housing development over on Normandy Avenue.
So?
I found some lumber over there, had the Keystone name printed on it.
We've been closed since 41. Never quite made the transition to talkies. The Suburban Redevelopment Fund are pulling the place down.
Know anything about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund?
Nix.
Mind if I take a look around?
I'm kind of hungry. If someone was to leave a couple of bucks here, I might wander down the street and get a cup of coffee.
Is there a key to the gate?
No. The only guys who go in or out are some delivery guys from Elysian Fields. They're working on a housing development over at Wilton and Santa Monica. You'll have to hop it.
The Suburban Redevelopment Fund pledges to speed up housing development for returning GIs.
Gentlemen, this is Dr. Harlan Fontaine. He's our latest investor in the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. Doctor, this is Curtis Benson. He's vice president of the California Fire and Life.
Pleased to meet you, Doctor.
Ray Gordon,
editor of the Times.
Doctor.
District Attorney Donald Sandler and police.
Police Chief Warren.
Gentlemen, I am delighted to be in such exalted company.
You're making quite a name for yourself, Doctor, amongst the thespian fraternity.
I find that those of artistic temperament are often of a fragile mental disposition.
It's a short step from miscreant to recidivism, Doctor.
Very true. But I think we could all agree that the City of Angels does rather well basking in the reflection of the motion picture industry.
Hear, hear. And it's something that every sucker getting off a train at Union Station wants a part of. Gentlemen, we're here to sell the American dream, and Hollywood is our greatest advertiser.
So, how is your new development selling, Leland?
Cannot throw them up fast enough, Ray.
And that's part of the problem, Leland. Washington is receiving steady complaints. There's a clamor for public
housing. God damn it, Ray.
Public housing is tantamount to communism. Now, that's why we fought this goddamn war. I'm telling you, it's Reds via the back door.
You can't have it both ways, Leland. The new freeways are being built to service all your developments out in the boondocks. They're all being built with government money.
The GI Bill is government money.
There's a difference.
What difference?
The GI money ends up in my pocket.
I hope you mean our pockets, Leland. We're all investors.
Of course, Curtis.
So, when will the freeway bond be passed on?
It still has to be ratified. Takes a long time to raise $3 billion.
I need to find a Gamewell or a telephone.
In a great day for the future of Los Angeles, civic leaders and businessmen join forces to launch the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. The Suburban Redevelopment Fund pledges to speed up housing development for returning GI.
Gentlemen, this is Dr. Harlan Fontaine. He's our latest investor in the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. Doctor, this is Curtis Benson. He's Vice President of the California Fire and Life.
Pleased to meet you, Doctor.
Ray Gordon, editor of the Times.
Doctor.
District Attorney Don Sandler and Police Chief Warren.
Gentlemen, I am delighted to be in such exalted company.
You're making quite a name for yourself, Doctor, amongst the thespian fraternity.
I find that those of artistic temperament are often of a fragile mental disposition. Short step.
Operator, think you could put me through to police dispatch? Thanks. This is Jack Kelso, investigator for California Fire and Life. Can you put me through to Curtis Benson, please?
Just a moment, please, Mr. Kelso.
Jack, how can I help?
Do you know anything about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund, Mr. Benson?
I've heard of them, Jack. Building new homes for GIs.
With green lumber that was used on movie sets.
Jack, are you working the Buckwalter case?
Mr. Benson, are you part of the Suburban Redevelopment Fund?
Jack, I want you to listen very clearly. Call Miss Lichtman. Call her as soon as you hang up. Arrange to see her tonight and get her to agree to the settlement. Do it tonight. Do you hear me?
Yes, sir.
End of story, Jack. I don't want to hear another word about Elsa Lichtman or Luke Buckwalter.
Can you put me through to Michigan 221?
Putting the call through.
Hello?
Ms. Lichtman, it's Jack Kelso.
Yes, Mr. Kelso.
I've been looking into your case.
Yes, and what have you found?
It doesn't look good. I need to see you.
Meet me at the Blue Room. I work there tonight. I take a break around 9. I'll be waiting at the stage door. We can talk then. Auf Wiedersehen, Mr. Kelso.
Thanks, ma'am.
I don't suppose I'll make
a plea. Cause baby, you know I'm guilty.
What were you doing with him?
I was doing what you asked.
I didn't ask you to meet him in an alleyway.
Why do you snarl at me? Your friend came to ask me to accept the insurance.
He's not my friend, Elsa.
I think he's a brave man, and you have placed him in great danger. You've involved him in something, and he has no idea of the risks. Can you live with that, Cole?
Elsa, I need his help. He hates my guts.
Forget the past, Cole. He deserves a chance to say no. If he helps you, let it be on his terms.
I'll go see him in the morning.
GI Los Angeles, Gene C. Wingle Incorporated, broadcasting since 1922.
I'm not thirsty. Nice wiring job, fellas. Keep them in the dark.
Lose something, Mac?
I thought these private eye types were all wise guys with smart mouths.
Looks like the snappy repartee has all dried up.
Get on with it.
What's your hurry, Mac? You got some place to go?
You ever do the cat and mouse routine without a gun in your hand?
Now that's more like it.
Tough guy. You should learn to take a hint. Get him downstairs and under the trunk. Sure, he turned up all right. He's wishing he didn't. He's in the trunk. He's going nowhere. The boys introduced themselves. What do you want done with him, Mr. Monroe? Yeah, I know a good place. I'll pick up a shovel and a pick on the way. It's up in the hills behind Griffith Park. We'll deal with that German bitch next.
Sorry, pal. Desperate times. Monroe owns the city. Owns the cops. I need to find Elsa.
California drivers.
Still carrying that Army 45, Cole.
For God's sake, Cole! Call an ambulance!
Satchel charges on the cave entrance from above. Covering fire on weapons team. Look for snipers in the trees. You know the drill. No risks, no heroes, no prisoners.
You want some roast on this one, Sarge?
No, you guys have done enough. Head back to weapons. We are going to blow every cave we come across. Close them down and move on, people.
Damn. I was hoping to get me a samurai sword.
Skipper says that Phelps has fallen behind again. He's got his fire teams checking every cave. He's lost another flamethrower. He wants you to get over there and hurry them along.
Hogaboom, weapons company.
Sir.
Sir.
We have a major cave complex in front of us, Hogaboom. I want flamethrowers and BAR teams to clean it out.
Begging your pardon, sir. But if it's a big complex, why don't we bring the Shermans in? They could pour it in there.
We can't wait for tanks to be brought up. I'm already behind.
Then blow the cave. No skin off our nose. Bury them.
We are going in there and clearing them out. We are doing it by the numbers, Sergeant. Get your team in place. We're moving out. Mount up! First fire team and flamethrowers, head in!
Where's he going?
Where's who going?
The big cowboy. He's going in.
Who gave that order?
You did.